An important application of derivative is mean value theorem. There are two mean value theorems, Rolle's theorem and Langevin's theorem. Today we are going to discuss Rolle's mean value theorem. Hello everyone, welcome to Maths is Easy. So let's get started. An important mean value theorem, Rolle's mean value theorem or Rolle's theorem. So let's get started. For what type of function Rolle's theorem can be applied? So we will start from here. What type of function? Suppose fx is a function such that fx is continuous in closed interval. Continuity means if we draw the graph of function, there should not be any break. So function should be continuous function. If we draw its graph, we should not lift the point of our pen. It should be a smooth curve. That is mean by continuity. Point 2. Function should be differentiable on AB. In open interval, function should be differentiable. Differentiable means what? It is a deep concept. What is mean by if a function is differentiable? There should not be a peak value. At the function is differentiable if through a point you can draw a tangent. So differentiability means if you can draw the tangent to the curve, it's differentiable function. So the function should be differentiable means we can draw a tangent to the curve. That is only differentiability. If a curve has this type of point, means it is not differentiable. So at open interval, on open interval, function should be differentiable. Why open? Open means you have to exclude A and B point. Because you have to take such a function at A and B point, you cannot draw tangent. Excluding A and B, at all the points you can draw tangent. So in other words, function is differentiable on open interval AB. Third condition, function's value at A should be function's value at B. Means function at A is equals to function at B. These three are the necessary condition for Rolle's theorem. So Rolle's theorem can be applied if these three conditions satisfied. If we have such a function, how many conditions are there? How many possibilities are there? Case 1, you have a function and at point A, suppose this is x is equals to A, and at point A, this is the function's value. At x is equals to A, this is the value of function. So we can say at x equals to A, function gets the value f of A. According to Rolle's theorem's third condition, at point B, at x is equals to B, whatever the function is, that should be equals to f of A. Means f of A equals to f of B as for the third condition of Rolle's theorem. So the both should be same. F of A should be equals to f of B. So the first possibility, we may have curve like this. And second possibility, suppose this is as x equals to A, and at A function has f of A. At x equals to B, function's value is f of B. So first possibility, second possibility. There is one more possibility that this is x equals to A and this is x equals to B. Function's value f of A is equals to function's value f of B. As they both are equal, so third condition is this, that f of A equals to f of B, and in between function can be oscillate between some values. So now let's move to the Rolle's theorem. What Rolle's theorem states? Rolle's theorem says any of these conditions, as this function is differentiable, means we can draw the tangent. Differentiability means we can draw the tangent. So at least one point between AB is such that, say it's x, at least one point C at which tangent is parallel to x-axis. At least one point exists between A and B at which tangent is parallel to x-axis. And tangent is parallel to x-axis means its first derivative at C is equals to 0. This is in first case. And if we have this case, so at between A and B, there is a point C at which tangent is parallel to x-axis. Means at this point f dash c equals to 0. Tangent parallel to x-axis means f dash c equals to 0. And if we have this type of auxiliary function, but still f of a equals to f of b, so there may be many possibility at which at point c1, suppose we have two points, first point is c1, second point is c2, and third point is c3. So according to Rolle's theorem, in this situation also, at least one point exists between A and B such that at which tangent is parallel to x-axis, means its first derivative would be 0. At least one point would be like this. There are three cases of Rolle's theorem, case 1, case 2, and case 3. And in what is the conclusion? Then there exists at least one point C between open interval AB such that at which tangent is parallel to x-axis, or first derivative at C is 0. This is Rolle's theorem. If any function satisfy these three conditions, first condition, function is continuous in closed interval, means we get a smooth curve. Second condition, function is differentiable, means there is no peak point or sudden turn, means we can draw a tangent in open interval AB, because we can clearly see that at A and B, function's tangent is not possible, means in between AB, function is differentiable. And the third condition is f of a equals to f of b. Then between a and b, there exists a point c such that at which the tangent is parallel to x-axis, or the first derivative at c is 0. This is Rolle's theorem. I hope you understood. Any of these cases, function will satisfy this condition, Rolle's theorem is true. And we can verify this theorem in any of the numerical question, any of the examples. Let's see a question. Fx equals to x square minus 4x plus 3 in interval 1, 3. One function is given, and it is basically a polynomial function, and interval is 1, 3. A is 1 and B is 3, and we have a polynomial. Every polynomial is always continuous and differentiable, so we can write straight away it's a polynomial function, so it is continuous as well as it is differentiable. So fx is continuous on AB, direct you can write, and here AB is 1, 3, so you can write directly. Fx is differentiable on open interval 1, 3. It is differentiable as it is polynomial. And third condition is f of a should be equals to f of b. What is f of 1? Let's find the value of function at 1. So 1 minus 4 plus 3 means it is 0, and at function at 3. So at 3 it would be 9 minus 12 plus 3. Yes, it is again 0. So f of a equals to f of b. The function is equal at a and b. So we can say yes, function is continuous, differentiable, and f of a equals to f of b. As all three conditions of Rolle's theorem satisfy for this particular function, so we must get a point c at which tangent is parallel to x-axis, or the first derivative would be 0. So first of all, differentiate the function. X square's derivative 2x minus 4. This is first derivative, and as per the Rolle's theorem, by Rolle's theorem, f dash c should be 0. At least one point c must be there in open interval. So f dash c equals to 0 means 2c minus 4 is equals to 0. And from here we can get c equals to 2. Is this 2 belongs to interval? Yes, 2 belongs to this interval 1 and 3. So Rowley's theorem verified we got a point 2 which is in this interval and at which function's first derivative is 0. So that is how to verify. अगर आप न्यू व्यूअर हो तो मैथ्स सीरीज को सब्सक्राइब जरूर कीजिए. हम जेई मेंस और कॉम्पिटिटिव की जो सीरीज़ चालू की है साथ में बोर्ड एग्ज़ाम को भी हम कवर कर रहे हैं. तो फॉर मोर वीडियोस डिटेल ट्रिक्स एंड शॉर्ट ट्रिक्स सब्सक्राइब मैथ्स सीरीज. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग.